Sometimes we don't know about the actual number of arguments can be used by a method in advance. In that case, we use variable number of arguments. Namaste everyone, I am Gyan and you are watching the session 18 of Java and Wave, String API in Java. Sometimes we do not know about number of arguments that can be used in a method in advance. For such a condition, we need variable number of arguments as formal arguments of a method. Here we have the Java file first.java. In the first.java we have the class first. In the class first we have two methods, the method f1 and the method main. The method main is calling the method f1, but the method f1 is using variable number of arguments. Notice here, the variable number of arguments will be of type integer, means whatever we need to pass to the method f1 should be of type integer. But how many integer values we can pass to the method f1, that is not fixed. To define variable number of arguments, we use the data type followed by three dots. Data type integer followed by three dots, followed by a space and followed by x. These three dots denotes the variable x is not of type integer, but the variable x is of type variable number of arguments of type integer. So when we declare a method by using variable number of arguments, then we can call that method by using variable number of arguments. We can call the method f1 by using one argument. We can call the method f1 by using two arguments. We can call the method f1 by using three arguments. In these three cases, the method f1 will be called and it will print var arg called. So does not matter how many arguments of integer type we are passing to the method. The same method gets called every time and it's printing three times var arg called. We have the Java file first.java. In the first.java we have the class first. In the class first we have the method main and the method f1. In the method f1 we are using a variable number of argument. Here one point you should notice, that internally the variable number of argument is treated as one dimensional array. So when you call the method f1 by using three integers, then the variable x will be treated as an integer array of three elements. So here in this case, internally the variable x is treated as an integer array of three elements. That's how here if you print x dot length, like that we can find length of an array. If you print here x dot length, it will print 3. So when you print the value of x0, it will print the first argument, that is 1. When you print the value of x1, it will print 2. When you print the value of x2, it will print 3. But when you print the value of x3, it will throw array index out of bounds exception, because an element at the index 3 does not exist. The fourth element does not exist. And as I already told you, if you print here x dot length, then it will print 3. This is the another example where we are using the array x, because internally the variable number of argument is treated as array. So we are using the array x in the enhanced for loop. In the enhanced for loop, we are extracting all the elements of the array x one by one and storing it into the integer variable y. Then we are printing the integer variable y. That's how it will print 1, 2 and 3. Since internally variable number of argument is treated as one dimensional array, so we cannot overload a method on this basis. We know that two methods in the same class cannot have same names and same signatures. That's how here in this case, we cannot have two methods with the same name and same signatures. As I already told you, the variable number of arguments is treated same as integer array. That's how in this case, the compiler will throw an error. Cannot declare both methods in first, in the class first. We can use variable number of argument in the place of array argument. That we can do. But we cannot use array argument in the place of variable number of argument. Since we can use variable number of argument in the place of array argument. That's how in the method main, instead of using a string array, we can use variable number of arguments of type string. We can use the variable number of arguments of type string instead of the string array in the method main. And that is perfectly valid. The three dots represent variable number of arguments. We cannot have two dots or four dots. The three dots after data type should be together and should be in between the data type and the variable. These three dots should be together without a space. and the combination of these three dots should be between data type and variable. So this one is correct, this one is correct, this one is correct, but this one is not correct because the three dots are used after the variable. Here we are giving a space between three dots, so this one is also not correct, and of course this one is not correct. We can use variable number of arguments together with normal arguments in method, but then variable number of arguments must be the last argument of the method. We cannot have more than one variable number of arguments together in a method. Here in this case, we are using a variable number of argument with another argument. If we are using the variable number of argument with another argument, then that variable number of argument should be in the last of the method definition. And we cannot have more than one variable number of arguments in a method definition. In this case, we are calling the method f1 by using three integers 1, 2 and 3. So the first n actual argument goes into first n formal arguments, and rest of the actual arguments gets assigned into the variable number of arguments. So 1 will go in the y, 2 will go in the 0th element of the x, 3 will go in the first element of the x. When we print the variable x0, it will print 2. When we print variable x1, it will print 3. When we print y, it will print 1. But when we print x2, in that case, it will throw array index out of bounds exception, because the length of the array is only 2 for the integers 2 and 3. Here in this case, we have the method f with three arguments, integer, float, and variable number of arguments of type integer. So when we call the method f1 by using three actual argument, the first one will be copied into the integer variable y, the 2 will be copied into the float z, and the 3 will be copied into the first element of the array x. The JVM will create an array of type integer of size 1, and that will store the integer 3. That's how this array has only one element at the index 0, which contains 3, because 1 copied into y, 2 copied into z, and only 3 has to be copied into x. So when you print x0, it will print 3, and when you try to print x1, the JVM will throw array index out of bounds exception. When you print y, it will print 1. When you print z, it will print 2.0. And again, when you try to print x2, the JVM will throw array index out of bounds exception, because there is only one element in the array x at the index number 0. We cannot have two variable number of arguments in a method, or a variable number of argument cannot be before any other argument in a method. If there is a variable number of argument in a method, then that variable number of argument should be the rightmost argument of the method. Here we are overriding the method f1. The first one has variable number of argument, and the second one has an integer variable. So when you call the method f1 without using any argument, in this case, it will call the variable number of argument with an array of size 0. When you call the method f1 by using only one argument, then most suitable method for this method call is this one, the method definition with only one integer as its argument. So 1 will be copied into x, and it will call the method f1. That's how here it will print normal. Again, when you call the method f1 by using two integer arguments, then it will call this variable number of arguments, because this is most suitable in this case. That's how when you call the method f1 by using two integers 1 and 2, it will print varArg. So that's all for this video, guys. Don't forget to like and share this video. Subscribe my channel on YouTube, like my page on Facebook, and leave your valuable comments in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.